Hello, I'm Trey Johnson with AHA TV, and I'm chatting with the editor-in-chief of circulation, Dr. Joseph Hill. Dr. Hill, what is it that you look for in research, and how do you decide what's published?
Our touchstone at circulation is validity. If a paper we feel is not valid, we will reject it immediately. We will not refer it. If a paper is potentially valid, then we will pursue a review process that is by design redundant, where every paper is evaluated by a senior editor or one or two or three, an associate editor, three or more peer reviewers, and then we have a discussion among ourselves weekly in a video call. So all our papers are evaluated by anywhere from 6, 8, 10, 12 different vantage points. But again, our touchstone is validity. If a paper is valid, but we feel that it is potentially too subspecialized for us or novelty is not at our priority level, we will often refer those to our subspecialty journal colleagues.
For authors looking to publish for the first time, the review process can seem overwhelming. Do you have any advice?
Well, I tell people in my lab, I'm an author too, right? We're all in this together. It's very easy to make good science look bad. It's very hard to dress bad science up and make it look good. You need to learn to tell a compelling story. You need to position your work in the field. You should not overstate it, but at the same time, you should highlight what is important about it. What I try to do when I write a paper, and every paper that comes out of my group gets rewritten by me many times, is to lay out an introduction that is short, three or four paragraphs, that sets the stage for there's something interesting here. There's an interesting problem. And I'm going to, if I turn the page and read further, I will be able to glean some insights that I didn't have before. You have to remember that the reviewers and the editors at some level are on your side. We're trying to make your science better. Now, it may not always feel that way, and I get it myself as an author, but you're asking someone to take their Sunday afternoon when they'd rather be out in the park with their kids and sit down and read your paper as a service to science and to our profession and to our journal. You owe it to them to make their job easy. Make it easy to read. Tell a story, a linear story, that draws the reader in, not only the reviewers, but of course the readers down the road. That is, I think, an important part of the process of obviously the validity and rigor and novelty of the science comes first.
And for people who aren't familiar with the process, could you walk us through what happens after someone submits a manuscript to circulation?
What we do is every paper is touched by a senior editor. We get 20 a day or so. So we will process to the next step about 50% of the paper, send it to an associate editor, and he or she will take a deeper dive into it and we'll send it out to two reviewers, sometimes three, and also a statistical reviewer. And depending, while that is happening, the associate editor will dig deep into the paper and make a decision based on his or her assessment. That decision will be confirmed or nuanced or altered or changed by the advice that comes in from the external peer reviewers. Then the paper comes back to a weekly discussion among the entire editorial team. And then it goes back to the authors. The paper, as I mentioned earlier, every paper is touched by many different editors and at least three different peer reviewers. And that is an intentionally redundant process because I'm convinced that there are many cases where the winds are blowing in one direction and then the 10th person in the conversation will say, but what about this? Something that we might've missed had we not had this multidisciplinary conversation among multiple professionals.
That is a thorough process. And the last question for you, what is it like to be an editor-in-chief?
Being an editor-in-chief is an honor and a privilege. It's an incredible learning process. It is a responsibility to oversee a team serving as gatekeepers for the future of cardiovascular science, the science that we promulgate in our journal. It's a heady responsibility that I can assure you I take very seriously, as do all the editors on our team. We have editors positioned in 17 different countries, and every one of them is a leader in the journal. We don't have international editors. We have editors. It doesn't matter if you're in Dallas, where I live, or in New York, or in Paris, or Santiago, or Tel Aviv, or Singapore. All our editors are the same. It is an absolute privilege to work with a team of capable leaders from around the world. Being an editor-in-chief is a busy job. I probably spend at least two hours a day, every day, some days more. It is a process where I get to learn about science from across a whole spectrum of approaches and questions. But I will emphasize that it is a privilege and an honor to be charged with overseeing this incredibly exciting process, to put together a workflow that I have described, to have novel different types of content, to get on my mind pieces from thought leaders around the world. It's a privilege and a joy, and it's something I love to do every day.
Thank you, Dr. Hill. Join us on AHA TV for additional conversations with editors-in-chief of the AHA journals coming up.